My name is Cindy. I'm from Dell Networking. Today, I'm going to go over how to update the I/O modules in the MX7000. We are going to be upgrading from 10.5.07 to 10.5.17 in this video. Before you get started, it is also good to know that before you update, you should be looking at the support matrix. The support matrix will go over which OEM, OpenManage Enterprise Modular version you should be on compared to, in our case, the switches, what versions they should be on. 10.5.07 is right here. So the OEM version should actually be 1.200. In our lab, we were actually currently on 1.30.00. However, our end goal would be reaching the latest version, which would be 10.5.24, which is like the current right now. Before we log into OEM, we also should download the packages that we need. Currently, all the versions are available on support.dell.com. Since we're going to 10.5.17, we'd go ahead and download it. The package we are looking for is the EXE. It's a Dell update package, so it can be pushed through OEM. I actually went ahead and already downloaded our package that we're going to use today. So we're going to go ahead and log into OEM. We're going to go to Devices, I/O Modules, and then we're going to select one of the switches in the Smart Fabric. If this was in full switch mode, we would select both. However, because we're in Smart Fabric, we only need to choose one and it will update both pairs. We would then click Update, Individual Package. Then we'd browse to our package. Once we locate our package, we would select the file, and the file will go ahead and upload to OEM. This can take several minutes, so you would need to be patient. Depending on your internet connection, it could go really fast, or if you're over a VPN, it'll take much longer. So keep that in mind when you're pushing packages to OEM for updating. Once the package completes downloading, you're going to see your 10.5.07 is your current version. You're going to see that you're not in compliance, and then you're going to go ahead and select the package. Click Next. On the Schedule Update page, you could decide if you would like to update now or schedule it later. Unfortunately for switches, reboot is required. The server options are not available to us, so we would go ahead and click Finished. In our scenario, we are going to update now. It's going to warn you that a reboot may happen, and then it asks you if you're sure you want to continue. So you go ahead and click Next. You're able to monitor the progress of the update by going to Monitor Jobs and then viewing detail on your running job. In the job details, you can see the percentage complete. So we're currently at 3%. If you go ahead and scroll down to the bottom, it's going to give us messages along the way. Right now, it's validating the package contents. As it progresses, it's going to go ahead and choose a switch and start updating it. Right now, it's showing target IOM A1. And then later it will show targeting A2. If you are interested to find out if the upgrades are going, you can log into your switches, locate which switch is the master of the Smart Fabric cluster. This is the master. This is the backup. In Smart Fabric, the backup switch should be updated first, and that is what the automation is going to do. You could see here that the package is 52% downloaded. And then on the master switch, there's nothing at all happening as of yet. And now that it's completed the transfer process, we can see that the install's in progress. In addition, you can find the image in the image directory. This is what OMI sent to the switch, and it is the bin file for upgrading to 10.5.1.7, which is why it's preferred to look to see what's going on through the CLI show commands. Otherwise, you can follow the update progress in OMEM and simply wait for it to complete. It does appear one of our switches have come back up. And our networks are there. We can see that we are still as the backup. And our VLTI link is up. I do see that the second switch has reloaded, and it does still show that the job status is running still. However, the switch is still in progress of coming up. So if we look over here, we should see that there was a failover. So show smart fabric cluster. And we should see that the master is now on A2, where before it was on A1. We're also going to show that on both switches, we're now on 10.5.1.7. And that our VLTI link is up. With VLT, it takes 90 seconds for the delay restore timer to reset. So we're currently seeing that port channel 6, which is our uplink, is down. It won't come up until after the delay restore timer is complete. So this is completely normal. 15 seconds left. We can see that all our networks are back up and our restore timer is complete. And now we are up with our uplink. So it may take several moments for our job to complete. In this case, it did, and it shows completed successful. You can return to the IOM modules and also view the firmware version on there. As you can see, 10.5.1.7. And on A2, we see the same. And that concludes my video for updating IOMs from 10.5.0.7 to 10.5.1.7. Have a great day.